I guess when I finished my BA in fine art and photography, I kind of entered into the world thinking, great, this is brilliant, this is me, somebody's going to pick me up and a gallery is going to want to show my work and it's going to help me financially. And I had very unrealistic, idealized sense of what was the approach you had to being an artist in the world. So after college, I was a bit clueless, actually. I was a bit lost. That transition of being really enthusiastic and excited about making work, but it's such a particular environment. You're not really made aware of the ins and outs and how important it is to be able to write about your work, to know about, to keep yourself informed about what's happening, commissions and awards and bursaries, etc. And I was a little bit lost on that. I didn't really know about that stuff. I was very happy and comfortable in the production and thinking and making of work. So that was a long and protracted learning curve that is something that perhaps could be made more aware of in college, but everyone has to go through this kind of process of how do you be an artist? What is it? For me, I had to move country to figure that out, and I came to London, and that was not necessarily, it was just to change everything, to be in a newer place, to be in a place where there was so many people who did the same thing as I did. There was so many interesting shows, amazing amount of artist talks that I had only read about. I'd never seen their work. I'd only experienced it through publications. You go to talks, to film screenings, the openings every night. It was just amazing, that kind of that change, I suppose. I hadn't quite even realized that was important to be, you know, to go to shows, to speak to other people interested in what you do. But for my kind of first shows, I guess there's always a sense of dread when you kind of allow the world to look at or this very small world, but to see your work, to see what you're up to. And to greater or lesser extents, whether I feel very confident about a piece of work or I'm not less sure, that dread goes up or down. So when you put work up in a gallery space, you are allowing the work to kind of live by itself. It has to. You've taken. The ownership is kind of released, and you have no idea really what's going to come back in terms of response. And it's a very weird sense showing work in a space because you are desperate to find out what people think about it. Yet, I mean, I think I'm pretty strong in terms of it's not going to crush me if I think it's criticism or people dislike the work. That's fine, I don't mind that. I quite like the idea that something would make a kind of a strong kind of reaction to somebody. What I would hate is someone to kind of go, oh, yeah, it's fine, I suppose. You know, the kind of non-reaction, non-emotion, that it's neither here nor there, not really engaging or not. But you let go of that, and I'm very interested in making to respond to the space that I show work in. So the site specificity of that is quite important, whether the work happens actually onto the walls or incorporates some sort of architectural element within the space. So work may look very different in one place to another. That makes it interesting for me, but it also makes it interesting, I think, for a viewer, perhaps. That it's not just this autonomous object that just can be plonked in one place or another. There is a response; it changes its meaning in one context to another. So that's kind of the way I've approached this exhibition as well in BCA, where. I'm aware of the audience and what type of audience the place has, and it's not really in the art crowd. I guess it's more general visitors, more general people, and I know that that's a concern that the gallery as a whole has in terms of bringing your average person, your non-art kind of expert into the space. And that's why I think I've kind of just wanted to make comments about the idea of the museum shop being an interesting place perhaps to think about it as bringing the shop into the gallery. Also these objects, bringing them into the gallery, and what that does. I generally think that the work is quite, my work is approachable. It can be read on a very immediate level. There is a sense of humor. I quite like the idea of having humor as part of work, or a curiosity, or it's a simple or small gesture, generally, my work. It's kind of a repositioning or an appropriation of images, and just by putting one image beside another, it gives it another meaning, and that's kind of what I'm interested in. So I guess my gesture as an artist is quite slight in some ways. It has been more, I produce images as well as appropriate images, but I quite like that idea of just looking at the world, observing the world, and gathering it and kind of paring it down, editing it, distilling it, and kind of repackaging it in order to comment about our society or our world or something. Not necessarily about grand things or themes, but perhaps these smaller little things represent larger things anyway.